Don Cockroft has the ball teed up. The Oakland Raiders, this is the near side. Their bench, the Browns on the far side. We're all set in the first meeting between the Oakland Raiders and the Cleveland Browns. The Raiders are set to receive this kickoff, and here to call the action for you is Gib Shanley.
Thank you, Jim Greenan. Good afternoon, everyone. The deep men for the Raiders, Alvin Wyatt, George Atkinson at the goal line. The kick by Cockroft is well hit. Taken at the 3-yard line by Atkinson. 10, right sideline, 15, 20, 25, and really upset hard by Freddie Summers at the 30-yard line. He was hit at the 26 and went through the air and was hit 4 yards before he fell down and all through the air. One of the Browns shaken up on the kickoff is rookie Bob McKay. He was hit hard on the block right at the point of the tackle. As you know, these are not timeouts charged in the NFL now on injuries unless he stays in the game. Of course, Bob won't stay in the game. He's not a member of the Browns defensive unit. He's being attended to now by Dr. Vic Ippolito and by trainer Leo Murphy. And while we have the time now, we'd like to, for the first time, say hello to our friends listening today on American Forces Radio Network. On being heard around the world, and they tell us that we're relayed to Europe by the ComSat satellite.
Gib, it looks to me like originally that he might have gotten in the shoulder, but now it is his left leg, and here come Chuck Reynolds along with Fred Hogan out to help Bob McKay off the field. He's going to be leaving the game. As you mentioned, he would have left anyway because he's just on the special team. But he really got banged up on that one, and I believe it's either his left knee or his left ankle. That's the leg that both the doctor and trainer Leo Murphy are looking at right now. And now McKay is on his feet, but he is being helped off, and this is, I would presume, a rather serious injury on right, the opening play of the ball game. Bob McKay, the number one draft choice, who was activated about 3 or 4 weeks ago, an offensive tackle, was slated to either spell off Dick Chaffrath or Bill Capone. He's been working both sides, and he is now leaving. And when play starts, the Oakland Raiders are on their own 30-yard line, and here it is.
Raiders out of the huddle. Seletnikov is the flanker to the right. Sherman is foot left. Hewitt Dixon is starting as a running back today. Hand off to Smith, right tackle, hit by Jim Houston at the 32-yard line, pulled down on about the 33, helped by Jerry Shirk, and on the bottom is Bob Matheson, the middle linebacker. Gene Upshaw, the left guard, pulled out to lead the blocking. Hewitt Dixon is starting at one of the running backs today. He's been injured. The other running back is Charlie Smith. Now, Maletnikoff is split 5-right. Sherman is the flanker to the left. And Chester, the slot end, is tight on the left side. Hand off to Dixon, trying to cut outside the end. Andrews sprung the play out, and it's going to be a loss. Back to the 29-yard line, 28-yard line, they'll mark it. Jack Gregory made the tackle, but it was Billy Andrews who sprung the play about 20 yards to the far side of the field. Now they mark at the 29-yard line. That brings up 3rd and 11.
Dixon has been bothered with several injuries, his knee and his shoulder. He only carried 6 times against Kansas City in the game in Kansas City last week. We'll see how far he goes this afternoon.
Poletnikoff is the flanker to the right. Sherman split about 7 at left end. And LaMonica probably to go to the air for the first play. He looks at the Browns' defense. He's going back to throw. He fires. It is caught at the 34-yard line. And I believe that one is Chester. It is not a first down by any stretch of the imagination. It was Charlie Smith who caught the ball. So it's 4th down, and the Raiders will have to punt. Walt Sumner and Reese Morrison go back in double safety. And Mike Eichheit will do the kicking for the Raiders. E-I-S-C-H-E-I-D. He's standing back on his 18-yard line. The safeties of the Browns back between the 20 and 30 of Cleveland. Good snap. One-man rush by Gregory. Beautiful kick. Sumner got it on the 23, heads for the right sideline. He is at the 30, and he's down on about the 31-yard line. a 46-yard punt. Man who made the tackle is Dwayne Benson, a stellar linebacker. Now the Browns today will have Nelson at quarterback, Leroy Kelly and Bo Scott, the runners, Gary Collins, the flanker, Milt Morin, I believe, is the slot end of it starting. No, it's Chip Glass starting at slot end. Sarah Hooker will be the split end. Browns the Chip out of the eye. Collins is flank right. Hooker split seven at left end. Nelson's going to throw on first down. Left sideline, incomplete. Intended for Leroy Kelly out at the 41-yard line. Collins had gone medium deep. Hooker very deep, and Kelly sneaked in behind him. Grayson covering.
Boy, and Nelson had an awful long time on that one. He says he can only expect about 3 or 3.5 seconds to get the pass away, but he had plenty of time on that one, and he had Kelly, but he just overthrew him down at about the 40-yard line.
Now, the Oakland Raiders up front have Tony Klein, Carlton Oates, Tom Keating, and Ben Davidson. Bill Lasky, Dan Connors, and Gus Otto are the linebackers. We'll get the rest in a moment. Second and 10. Hooker flanks left. Collins splits about four at right end. Handoff is to Bo Scott over left guard to the 35-yard line. A pickup up about 4 yards. Connors and Grayson on the tackle. It'll be third down and six. The cornerbacks for Oakland are Kent McCroon and Nehemiah Wilson. The safeties are George Atkinson and Dave Grayson. The rest of the Browns lineup, the tackles are Dick Schaffrath and Joe Stefoni. The guards are John Damari and Gene Hickerson, and Fred Hoagland's the center. Third and six, Cleveland out of the huddle on their own 35-yard line. Hooker, flank left, Glass out two at left end. Collins splits seven at right end. Nelson to throw. Left sideline, and it's overthrown out of bounds. At the 50, probably intended for Chip Glass, and I think thrown away by Nelson with nobody open.
Yeah, I noticed that McLuhan is using that real bump-and-run tactic against Gary Collins. He goes right up on the line, while Nehemiah Wilson, the right cornerback, against a fair hooker, is about 5 yards off the line of scrimmage. And that time, the Raiders had a six-man line because they're going to rush Nelson with that third down and long yardage. And here's the punt.
Neither team could move it on three plays. Now this will be the Browns' first punt. Rob Sherman and Alvin White in double safety. Don Cockroft gets it away. High, high, wobbly kick. Sherman calls for the fair catch, holds it on the Oakland 27-yard line. Raiders to put it in play again in their own territory. There's an official timeout on the field. The score, the Browns nothing, the Raiders nothing.
If you tell a man to make your beer Duke, whether in bottles, cases, or on tap, more people every day are discovering the deep down satisfaction that comes with every sip of Duke. Try a Duke today. All you have to lose is your thirst. Be a winner. Try a Duke.
Join the Barons and the Cavaliers for excitement all winter long in the Cleveland Arena, the new home of Duke Beer.
Oakland starting play on their 27, first and 10. Biletnikoff has split five to the right. Sherman the flanker to the left. Give to Hugh Dixon. Left tackle, small hole, pipe off one tackle, hits the 30 to the 32-yard line. A good, hard, short run by Hildreth Dixon. Jack Gregory finally made the tackle, along with Billy Andrews. That was a 38-yard punt by Cockroft. That's a 5-yard gain by Dixon, second and five. 11:26 remaining, first quarter. No score. Sherman has split seven to the left. Biletnikoff flank right. Chester tight at right end. Hand off. Smith trying to cut around right end. 35 out of bounds. Close to a first down on the 37-yard line. Bob Matheson got him out of bounds. Very close to the first down. And it is. By half the length of the ball.
I notice neither wide receiver goes down in that three-quarter stance. Both of them just stand straight up.
Sherman has split seven to the left. Biletnikoff flank right. Hand off. comes to Big Dixon over left guard to the 40 to the 41-yard line. Be a pickup of about 4 yards. Walter Johnson and Bob Matheson on the tackle. Jim, isn't Biletnikoff the boy who signed his first pro contract under the goalpost after his final college?
I think that was Cannon, wasn't it?
Was it?
Yeah, I think that was Billy Cannon.
It was the Oakland team, though.
Right.
Second down, 6. LaMonica to throw. Fires, hook pattern, dropped by LaMonica at the 49-yard line. Just couldn't hang on to it. Biletnikoff, LaMonica threw it. Erie finds behind Biletnikoff.
Gibb, the Vikings have defeated the Washington Redskins 19-10, so they are 7-1 in that tough central division of the National Football Conference.
That was a 16-10 game through most of the fourth quarter. Now, Biletnikoff is the slot left, and Sherman is foot left. And LaMonica back to throw deep in the pocket. He's hit as he fires. It's up in the air, and it's instantly off the hands of Chester. They slot in. He bobbled that one. The Browns were down around Chester's legs. They might have had an interception had either Billy Andrews or Erich Barnes been standing. Good fourth down coming.
Boy, LaMonica sent all five receivers on that, having three to the left and two on the right side, with the tight end Chester cutting over the middle. All five of them out on that play.
And he does that more often than not, sends all five out. Eichard to punt, standing at the 25. Sumner and Morrison are deep. High snap. Kick is away. Beautiful kick. Fair catch by Walt Sumner. He has it at the 15-yard line. So that's where the ball will be put in play. There's an official timeout on the field with the score. The Browns nothing, the Raiders nothing.
Brings you more of the sound of beautiful music on WHK Radio. This is Joe Black inviting you to join our sponsors starting Sunday mornings at 9:45 and enjoy our special way of presenting hour-after-hour medleys of all your favorites. Familiar chimes in between long enough to identify titles and performing artists. The success format adult listeners of all ages continually find a real pleasure listening to. Journey into Melody on 1420 Radio, WHK.
That was a 44-yard punt by Eichheit. Browns out of the huddle. High formation, shift out of it now. Hooker split five left. Collins the flanker to the right. The Browns back stay in the eye. Kelly gets the handoff, right tackle to the 19-yard line. Pickup of about 4. That's the first time the Browns have run out of the eye formation in probably 2 or 3 games. Connor's the middle linebacker on the tackle along with Klein, the rookie defensive left end. Browns line up in the stacked eye and they shift out of it, getting the slot end out of there, leaving just the plain eye. Second and 6. Hooker flank left. Glass tight at left end. Collins out 4 at right end. They're in the teeth. Give to Kelly. Left tackle. No hole. Hit at the 20. Down on the 20. And who made the play is the right linebacker, Gus Otto. Just fought off the block and made the tackle. And then had help by Tom Keating. A gain of a yard, 3rd and 5. A little bit right now. Not opening anything with their offense. Collins flanks far to the right. Hooker out 5 at left end. Glass out 2 at right end. Nelson to throw. In the middle. It's incomplete. Too low. Off the hand of Chip Glass at the 31-yard line. He's shaken up a little bit on the play. He may have had his hand stepped on. Atkinson was covering on the play. Now Glass is up and he's clear to be all right. So the Browns will have to punt again. Now the line of scrimmage is that 20-yard line. So the Oakland Raiders have been gaining a slight amount of yardage on the exchange of punts. Cockroft to punt for Craven, standing at the 6. Deep men are Wyatt and Sherman.
for the Raiders. Good snap. Kick is away. End over end.
Sherman on the 50. 45. Tipped down on the 41-yard line by Ken Brown.
So they do get good field position on a short low kick. A 30-yard punt, but it was low and playable. Now the Raiders have field position. That's a difference of about 40 yards where they started the other series, but we must remember that the Raiders did pick up the first down, for the only first down, and both quarterbacks have gone to the air three times. We have just the one completion by LaMonica. Of course, he's had two of his passes dropped. Poletnikoff is a slot left, Sherman split left, and LaMonica's going to throw it, and there's a bomb. It's overthrown at the 10-yard line, intended for his running back, Charlie Smith. Jim Houston covering on the play. Smith had a couple of steps on Houston. But I think Jim started to pull up when he saw the ball being overthrown. Boy, you get your running back going that deep along with Poletnikoff on the right side, you get a couple of threats. Especially when the linebacker is responsible on those plays for the running back, and he's got to go deep with him. So you got to be fast.
Now, Poletnikoff is split far to the left, and Sherman is a slot left. Second and 10. Back to throw goes Poletnikoff. And another bomb. And that one's overthrown, same play. This one is to Larry Todd, who just came in the ball game replacing Smith, so they're alternating the running back and giving Jim Houston a long run for his money. Mike Powell had dropped back to help Houston, however. LaMonica likes to throw bombs.
And once again, he had all five receivers out on that. As you mentioned, he does that quite frequently. Well, the question is it better to go along, or actually you take a look at these statistics, and LaMonica, the long one, Nelson, the short one, are 1-2 and very close.
Poletnikoff again, split left, Sherman slot left, LaMonica to throw. Screen to the left, to Smith, 45, 40, flips and goes down, luckily for the Browns, on the 36-yard line. He still has some daylight. Matheson then touched him. Billy Andrews is getting up slowly. Now he seems to be all right. And the Oakland Raiders are going for the field goal. Old George Blanda is going to try one. He's getting a hand as he comes out on the field. LaMonica will hold for him. It'll be about a 42. Well, they're marking at 43 yards. Angle slightly to the left. 7:40 remaining. Clock is running. No score yet. Waiting for the snap. There it is. The ball is down. The kick is up. It's far enough. It is good. There's an official timeout on the field with the score. The Raiders 3, the Browns nothing.
In 1900, Johann Hustlinger decided to set a world record, so he stood on his hands, walked out of Vienna, and 841 miles later strode into Paris on his hands. It'll take a good man to beat that record, but records are made to be broken. For instance, right now, the 16 good sports Chevy dealers are breaking money-saving records on the 71 Chevy. Now you can save an extra $25. How? Get a $25 record breaker coupon from the good sports Chevy dealers ad in the Brown football program. Or write to me, Gib Shanley, WHK, and I'll mail you one. One to a family. Take your coupon to your nearby Good Sport. Look at the 71 Chevys, talk to the salesman, place your order, then hand the salesman your record breaker coupon. He'll subtract $25 from his quote. And you don't have to go far, on your hands or otherwise, to get expert service on your car. With 16 Good Sport Chevy dealers in town, there's one near where you live or work. Yes, it's a fact. When you buy a 1971 Chevrolet, you win big.
Mike Eisheit is going to kick off. He used to be the field goal kicker, too, for Oakland until they acquired Blanda. Blanda, by the way, was 50% on his field goals going into today's game, 8 out of 16. So now he has 9 off that 43-yarder, which puts the Raiders up with about 7.5 minutes remaining. And the Browns have yet to pick up the first down. Kelly has 5 yards, Scott 4, and Nelson has yet to complete a pass. So they're going to get another shot at it here midway in the first period.
Eisheit kicking to either Homer Jones or Reese Morrison. Back at the 2. That's well hit. Homer Jones on the goal line. Up to the 5. 10, right sideline. 15, 20, 25. Hurdles a man. 30, 35, 37. Down on the 39-yard line. A good return of 39 yards by the Browns. Swifty. And Bluey makes the tackle.
He had the wedge of about seven men. The return was to the right. And he almost broke loose, but he had two men between him and the goal line when he was brought down almost to the 40-yard line. As you mentioned, good field position.
Browns come out of the huddle in the stacked eye, shift now to the tee. Hooker flanks to the left. Collins puts four at right end. And there's an offside in the middle of the line. The ball is snapped. Nelson just holds on to it. Whistles blow. Play stopped. Appeared to be against Oakland. It is. 5 yards to the 44. Called illegal procedure. Tom Keating is the tackle, who was right over the center. Fred Hoagland is the man who moved. Get a break after this next play. First down and five. 7 minutes to play. First quarter. Raiders lead 3-0. Hooker flanks left. Collins out four to the right. Last out about a half yard at left end. Hand off on a trap to Kelly. No hole. Slammed down on the 45-yard line. Hard tackle by middle linebacker Dan Connors. 10 seconds for station identification. This is the Cleveland Browns Football Network.
This is WHK 1420 Cleveland, where Browns quarterback Bill Nelson is your Monday morning quarterback, 8 to 9 a.m. tomorrow morning.
Second down, about five and a half to go. Brown shifts out of the eye. Hooker split left, about seven. Collins flanked to the right. On the draw, both scout over left side, not much of a hole, to about the 47-yard line. And again, Dan Connors, the middle linebacker, made the tackle. The defensive unit is much stronger for Oakland since Connors came back from an injury. Ben Davidson helped on that stop. It's third and about three.
And it looked like they were a little confused lining up on the defensive line. They were shifting in and out, and they were still moving when the Browns put the play in action.
5:48 remaining, first quarter. Now Hooker is flipped about 10 to the right, and Collins is slot right. Glass out two at left end. Take handoff. Nelson to throw. Deep in the middle. Collins, and it's overthrown at the 20-yard line, and he had his man beat Wilson by about two steps. Ball was just slightly overthrown. A little bit of pressure on Nelson, and they can get rid of it in a hurry. Before he wanted to, anyway. Collins would probably not have touchdown. Didn't have that big a lead, but he certainly would have had a big, big game. Browns will have to punt. Wyatt and Sherman in double safety. Cock off the punt. Low snap. Kick is away. Beauty. Whoa. Way back. Wyatt lets it hit on the three. It dies on about the 4-yard line. Freddie Summers of the Browns didn't see it. Turned his back on it. And then one of his teammates grounded the ball, and the Raiders will now start play on the 3-yard line. Dale Lindsay, the man who grounded the football. A 50-yard punt. Now the Raiders in the hole. 5:20 to play, first quarter. Raiders lead by three. Kolesnikoff is flanked to the right. Sherman with seven at left end. Everybody moving, and the ball is not snapped. Mary Shue, the right tackle, is in the Browns' backfield. That'll be against the Raiders. Half the distance for the one and a half. Illegal procedure. Everybody moved except the ball. And Bolotnikoff flanking to the right. Sherman up, about seven at left end. Chester tight at right end. Dixon over left guard. Walter Johnson and Jerry Shirk are there to nail him. Forward progress will be to about the 2-yard line. So it's second down and about 11 to go. The LaMonica is the kind, Jim, that might just throw a long one right here.
Well, we're going to know pretty soon. He's in real ticklish position when you're inside your own 5-yard line. Let's see what he does on this one.
A left the car flank to the right. Sherman slips five to the left. LaMonica goes back to throw. He's hit as he drills it deep in the middle. It's overthrown at the 30-yard line.
And the intended receiver is Ray Chester, and Ernie Kellerman had stumbled just before the ball came down, or he might have had a better shot at it than Chester. Ernie did not see the ball.
And he had his two wide receivers. Both were open. Both were going to sideline patterns, especially Biletnikoff. Erich Barnes was protecting against him inside, and he let him get outside, and he went to the sideline, and he could have picked up the first down had he and he gone to the wide receiver on the right.
Browns were right on LaMonica, too. He threw that one just as he got a snoop full of somebody's arm.
Biletnikoff, flank to the right. Third and 11 at the two, and LaMonica's going to try to throw it again. He fires. It is caught at the 16-yard line. That will be Sherman out of bounds by Sumner, and it's a first down. Just got it by about 3 yards to spare.
And I'll tell you, it took a good catch because Walt Sumner can't be faulted on that. He had to protect deep, and then it was just kind of a sideline hook pattern, and he was right there and just missed knocking the ball out of his hand. It was a nice catch on the part of Sherman, who was filling in for Warren Wells.
Now Biletnikoff splits right, and Sherman is a slot right.
Hand off to Dixon.
Left tackle, a hole to the 20, down to the 24-yard line. Kellerman on the make that Mike Howell on the tackle.
That's a pickup
of about 8.
Make it 7.5. The ball on the 23.5 right now. 3:55 to play, first quarter. Raiders lead 3-0, and have moved it out now from there, too. Biletnikoff flank to the right. Sherman is split 5 at left end. Chester tight at right end. Gives again to Dixon. Outside the tackle. Can't get any room and finally gets pulled down just over the 25-yard line. He had to dive to get that much as he was caught at the ankle by Erich Barnes and Ernie Kellerman. And they're going to measure to see if it's a first down. From here, I don't think it's about 2 inches short.
It does look short, but this is just the third down coming up. So if they don't make it, they don't have to punt yet. They're gonna miss it by an inch or two. Make the third down in just that distance. The Browns are trying to force them to punt and perhaps try to get the ball in and around the 50.
Hubbard is in at fullback, replacing Dixon.
He's a boy that substituted for him last week to give against the tough Kansas City Chiefs, and he picked up close to 100 yards.
Now, Biletnikoff splits left, Sherman slot left. Chester tight at right end. Give to Hubbard, right up the middle, first down. All the way to the 30. Matheson on the tackle. Got the first down, plus 4 yards. Hubbard is 6'1", 215, not as big as Dixon, who is 6'1", 230. Hubbard is from Colgate.
They say that Dixon reached his current proportion of size when he was a teenager, if you can imagine that.
Hand off to Smith, trying to turn the end, cut back inside, and knock down on the 35-yard line. That's still a pickup of 5. Matheson on the stop. Snyder helped on at the left end. Second and a... Well, they'll throw another ball in. We'll see where they finally put it down. It's going to be a little under 5 yards to go. About 4.5. 2:20 to play, first quarter. Sherman is the flanker to the left. Biletnikoff splits 3 at right end. Give to Hubbard, left tackle, big hole, 40, down on the 43-yard line. Walter Johnson on the tackle along with Bob Matheson. They really pushed Jerry Shirk right out of that play. And right past him. That was Gene Upshaw, the great left guard for the Oakland Raiders. We're under 2 minutes remaining in the first period. Oakland on the move now to the 43 from their own 2. Biletnikoff split right, Sherman slot right. Hand off. Smith on a drive, 50, into the ground, 46-yard line. Mike Howell and Ernie Kellerman, the safeties on the tackle. Matheson helped. Oh, the Raiders are really chewing up yardage on the ground now.
Oh, they're opening big holes in that Brown line, Gibb. And it seems to be, at least on that one, was just between the tackles almost straight over center.
A minute remaining in the first quarter. And a whistle. I believe the Browns have asked for a time.
They have.
We have a minute
2 remaining in the first quarter. And the Raiders really have some drive moving. It's now 48 and 4, 52 yards they've moved it.
And Daryl LaMonica comes over to talk to John Madden, the head coach, during this timeout. The Raiders with their 43-yard field goal from George Blanda, about halfway mark of the first period. That's the way all the scoring in this particular ball game. The Browns have punted already in the first period 3 times. They've been unable to move the ball, and Nelson has been a little long on a couple of his passes. He stands 0 for 4, while LaMonica is 3 out of 8 for a total of 23 yards. But on the ground, they have gained 42, 50, 54 yards. Most of their yardage has been on the ground so far today. But we mentioned earlier that this ball club leads both in passing and in rushing and total offense in the American Football Conference. LaMonica now rejoins his teammates in the huddle with the play.
Jim will have a couple scores for you as soon as we go through at least one play. The Raiders are out of the huddle. First down and 10 on the Cleveland 46-yard line. Beletnikoff has split 10 to the left, and Sherman has slot left. Hand off, Dick to Hubbard up the middle, to the 40, to the 39-yard line. Ron Snyder on the tackle, along with Mike Howell.
Boy, he started out to the left and then reversed his field right in the middle of that line and got down inside the 40. San Francisco beat Chicago 37-16. Pittsburgh beat the Jets 21-17. Giants over Dallas 23-20. How about that one, a final? 43-14, Cincinnati over Buffalo, Minnesota. Philadelphia 24, Miami 10 is the final.
Belitnikoff is split left. Sherman again, slot left. Second down, about 3 to go. Hand off, Charlie Smith, right tackle. He's down to the 35-yard line. Walter Johnson, Erich Barnes. First down for the Raiders.
Boy, it doesn't make much difference, Gib, which side of the line they're running through. Equal success, their left to their right.
There's the gun. That's the end of the first quarter with the score, Oakland 3, Cleveland nothing.
There are some things money cannot buy, like experience, trust, confidence. But these are the things you get when you borrow from Household Finance. Household advisors never borrow money needlessly. Yet after 92 years of lending experience, they know how important money needs can be. More than 2.5 million families each year trust the company where they can borrow with confidence.
Never borrow money needlessly, but when you need to borrow,
that's Household Finance. There are 1,600 HFC offices throughout the U.S. and Canada. See your phone book for the one nearest you.
In this particular drive, the Raiders on the move down to the Browns 35. They've only gone to the air once. And that was the pass to Sherman, which picked up the big first down on their own 16, which kept the drive alive.
Todd is in at running back, replacing Smith. Beletnikoff is the split end to the left. Sherman slot left. Fake handoff. LaMonica drills it deep, and it is incomplete. But the goal line broken up by Mike Powell. He had a shot at it. Had double coverage that time. Kellerman and Howell against Rod Sherman. Howell, of course, the free safety, came over on the play. Had to go high in the air to deflect it. Second and 10 on the Browns 35.
I don't know where Mike was when the play was, the ball was halfway in the air, say, along about the 25, but he got there in a hurry. It was the post pattern, and it was fortunate for the Browns that he did, because Ernie Kellerman was being beaten on the post pattern.
Beletnikoff split left, Sherman slot left. Back to throw, Lamont, screen to the left flat. It's been caught out there by Todd. Hit from behind on the 29-yard line by Shirk and slammed down at the 26-yard line. That will bring up a third and about 2. And Smith coming back in, replacing Todd in the backfield for Oakland.
third and two, and you've been very successful on the ground, but you got to be careful with LaMonica might go to the air, so let's see how the Browns defend this particular play.
LaMonica's going to throw it.
Drills it left sideline, man open, Smith at the 10, ball, touchdown.
Beatty's outside linebacker, Billy Andrews, who wasn't within 5, 6, 7 yards of him.
That comes with 13:59 remaining in the second quarter. 27-yard touchdown pass from LaMonica to Charlie Smith. Point now by Blanda. LaMonica holding at the 10. Snap, spot, kick is up. It's good. There's an official timeout on the field to score. The Raiders 10, the Browns nothing.
Next to you enjoying an ice-cold Duke beer. Look at the rich, creamy collar, bubbling with natural beer flavor. The cold, right now taste of Duke is pure beer-drinking pleasure. Tell the crowd to move over. There's always room for another Duke drinker. Be a winner. Try a Duke.
Join the Barons and the Cavaliers for excitement all winter long in the Cleveland Arena, the new home of Duke Beer.
Another game in which George Blanda has scored. He has a string, as we mentioned, of consecutive extra point attempts. 177 that makes it. 234, as we mentioned earlier, is the record. And he also has a consecutive streak going as far as scoring in a ball game. But he is far in the way of that record. Sam Baker has that of 110. 98 yards in 14 plays for the Raiders on that particular drive. And the Browns were in good position, having them deep in their own territory with a big third down, and then went to the air and got the first down on the pass to the sideline to Sherman. Kansas City leading Houston 24-9 in the fourth period. Here's the kick by Eichheit.
Homer Jones under it.
At the goal line, a 5-10, right sideline, 20, 25, flag down, 30, 33-yard line. And we probably have a clip. That's usually the case. Alvin Wyatt is the man who made the tackle. And it'll be against the Browns.
Marked at the 21-yard line. That'll put it back on about the 10.5.
Yeah, here's one for you. Fourth period. It isn't over. New Orleans leads Detroit 16-14.
That'll be fun, won't it? All right, the Browns on the 10.5-yard line. First down and 10. Milt Morin is in now slot end, replacing Chip Glass. Collins flank right. Hooker out 5 at left end. Morin tied at right end. Give to Kelly. No hole. Right tackle. Pulled down right on the line of scrimmage by Tom Keating. I'd like to remind all of you Browns fans, and as well as you servicemen listening, wherever you may be, that we have Cleveland Browns decals for your windows. And you servicemen, if you'll let us know where you are, what part of the world, they'll also send you one. If you'll just send a self-addressed stamp envelope to Decal, WHK, 5000 Euclid Avenue, Cleveland. We'll repeat that in a second. Second down and 10. Now the Browns have a flood formation to the left, and the gift of Kelly, he is hit again at the line of scrimmage, and a flag on the play. Davidson's the man who made the tackle. We have a penalty against Oakland, however, of 5 yards. That was called by the line judge offside. He's on the opposite side of the field from the head linesman. It is now second down and 5 to go. Again, if you'd like the decal, please send a self-addressed stamped envelope to Decal, WHK, 5000 Euclid Avenue, Cleveland. Browns on their 15-yard line. Hooker flank left. Morin out 2 to the left. Collins out 4 to the right. Nelson to throw.
A slant batter. It's hit high in the air, and it is intercepted down on the 20-yard line. I can't get a number. I believe it was 45, given not sure. Dave Grayson. It is Grayson. The man who deflected it was Wilson. That ball must have gone 30 feet straight up in the air, and everybody came out after it. So the Raiders get the ball at the 20.
That's as high as we've seen it deflected, and Fred Hogan was right there. I thought maybe he was going to get it at the last moment.
Well, a big break for Oakland, and they send Bolotnikoff split to the right, Sherman slot back to the right. Handoff, big handoff. LaMonica is going to throw it in the end zone. And it's an interference call. It was batted away by Sumner, intended for Chester, but he had his hand in front of the receiver. They may call face guarding. They're going to put the ball on the 1 yard line.
Jim, I thought the rule read if you're going for the ball that it's legal, and he did deflect the ball.
On the face guarding, you mean?
Yes,
that's true. And I don't think that he was waving his hands too much, but they're calling it interference.
Again, we have the slot formation to the right. Ball is on the one, first and goal. And off Smith, left tackle, he slammed down on the 1 yard line. Billy Andrews is on the tackle. Bob Matheson is on the bottom of the stack. Second down and goal at the one. Oakland already leading 10-0. And it's 12-10 remaining in the first half. Again, Bolotnikoff split right, Sherman slot right. Take handoff. Bolotnikoff throws it. It's incomplete and almost intercepted in the end zone by Erich Barnes. It was right down at his feet, and he couldn't quite reach down after it. He is really upset about it. Smith, the intended receiver. Now it's third down and goal.
Yep, I don't know whether that ball was deflected by one of the rushing linemen or not. It looked like it did because it wasn't a spiral after it got halfway there because it was just not exactly an end over end, but it was lobbing. It may have been deflected.
Hubbard has gone in replacing Dixon now, fullback. Again, Bolotnikoff split right, Sherman slot right. Third and goal of the one.
Give to Hubbard, straight ahead. No, sir. He's still down on the 1 yard line. Did not get anything. And again, Matheson's on the bottom. Let's see who else gets up. I think that's Walter Johnson. It is. It is fourth down and goal to go. And the Raiders are going for the field goal. And the fans don't like it.
Well, this is a smart thing to do, of course, because if you go for it and you don't make it, this could be a real morale and spirit builder for the Cleveland Browns if they could hold a team like the Raiders scoreless from the 1 yard line. So they at least want to get something up on that board.
9 yard field goal. LaMonica holding for Blanda. Good goal line stand by the Browns. Snap, spot, kicks up. It's good. There's an official timeout on the field with the score, the Raiders 13, the Browns nothing.
WHK presents The Sound of Beautiful Music. The same for you 24 hours a day on WHK 1420.
Denver just a few percentage points behind Oakland in their bid for the Western Division in the American Football Conference, trails San Diego 3-0. Oakland and Denver will play in Denver next week. The Browns' total offense is 12 yards, 5 for Kelly, 7 for Scott. They've got to get something moving here.
There's a long, long driving kick. Hits the goalpost. Then bounced over and hit Joe Ligeti, one of the blockers. Of course, it's a dead ball. And the Browns will start play at the 20-yard line. Browns have not been moving the football here in the first half so far. Of course, it's still early in the game. But Oakland's defense has been extremely tough against the run. Browns in the slot eye, the stack eye, shift out of it. Hooker, flank left. Collins out four at right end. Give to Kelly, left tackle, small hole. Tyson squirms to the 23, a gain of three. Keating and Klein made the tackle. Klein's a rookie defensive end.
The Browns were hoping, I'm sure, to control the ball and keep it away from Oakland. This was their plan. But they haven't been able, as Gibb has mentioned, and as you can tell by the statistics, they haven't been able to move it. And as a matter of fact, I don't think they have a first down.
Collins, flank to the right, Hooker up, about five at left end. Give the Bo Scott right guard. There's a small hole. He hits the 25 to the 30-yard line, and he's over the stripe, and I believe he has the first down. Tom Keating and linebacker Bill Lasky on the tackle, and it is a first down. Ball resting just outside the 30. .10:05 to play, first half. The Raiders lead 13-0.
From Oakland. This was their plan, but they haven't been able, as Gibb has mentioned, and as you can tell by the statistics, they haven't been able to move it. And as a matter of fact, I don't think they have a first down.
Collins, flank to the right, Hooker up, about five at left end. Give the Bo Scott right guard. There's a small hole. He hits the 25 to the 30-yard line, and he's over the stripe, and I believe he has the first down. Tom Keating and linebacker Bill Lasky on the tackle, and it is a first down. Ball resting just outside the 30. .10:05 to play, first half. The Raiders lead 13-0. Collins, flank to the right. Hooker out seven at left end. Give to Kelly, right guard. He's pulled down at the 32-yard line. Lasky, the linebacker on the left side, again made the tackle along with Keating. John DeMarre is going off the field. And just as right true, Jim Copeland in to replace him at left guard. Kelly now carried six times for a total of 10 yards. Scott has 14 yards and three carries. It's really been tough moving against this Raider line. Second and eight. Collins slipped forward to the right. Hooker flank left. DeMarre out a yard at left end. On the draw, Bo Scott is tripped up at the line. No gain on the play, and the man who tripped him up is, again, Tom Keating. It's third and eight.
And this is obviously going to be a passing play. The Browns are going to have to start getting cute now, use some of these ends around to the halfback option pass.
Collins now is split left. Hooker is the slot left. Take handoff. Nelson to throw. It is overthrown. Intended for Kelly out at the 45-yard line. And good coverage on him by Otto, the right linebacker. And the Browns will have to punt.
There was no doubt about that. He had great coverage. The Kelly just never was open, and that's why Bill just had to throw the ball away. Matter of fact, they had fine coverage as four receivers went out, and they were all covered pretty well. Of course, they knew the pass was coming.
Get a break after this play. Cockcroft punt to either Sherman or Wyatt. Standing there back on their 35. Off the right side of his foot. Hits on the 34, takes a Cleveland bounce down to the 20, to the 17, and rolls dead at the 17. 10 seconds for station identification. This is the Cleveland Browns Football Network.
This is WHK 1420 Cleveland. Spend your midday with Tall Ted Haliman 10 to 1 and Frank McHale 1 to 4, featuring beautiful music and good, clean fun.
And there's an official timeout on the field with the score, the Raiders 13, the Browns 10.
Stroud, England, July 22nd, 1967. Warren Burley picks out his 5-pound building brick, walks to the line, and lets it fly. 136 feet. The old brick-throwing record's been broken, but records are meant to be broken. That's why the 16 good sports Chevy dealers have come up with the idea that breaks all money-saving records for the 71 Chevy. Here it is. Tear out the $25 record-breaker coupon from the good sports Chevy dealers ad in the Browns football program. Or write me, Gib Shanley, WHK, and I'll mail you one. One to a family. Put the coupon in your wallet, then go to your nearby good sports Chevy dealer. Look at the 71 Chevys. Pick out yours, order it. Now show the salesman your coupon. He'll subtract $25 from his quote. That's for the record. So is this. Over half the Cleveland Chevy buyers don't bother shopping around. They get the car and the deal they want from the good sports Chevy dealers. When you buy a 1971 Chevrolet, you win big.
On the first play from scrimmage, standing at the 17, Hubert Dixon gets the handoff, moves over left tackle to the 21, almost the 22-yard line. Gain of about 4.5 after Cockcroft's 51-yard punt. Second down, about 5.5 to go. Sherman's a slot right, Beletnikoff split right. Just out about a yard at left end. LaMonica. Hands to Smith. Not much of a haul. He's hit hard on the 21-yard line. The man who sealed that one is Billy Andrews, the right linebacker. They lost about a yard on the play. Almost two. And here is Joe Jones coming in at defensive left end, replacing Snido. Among other things, the Browns expect a pass on third and seven. Going to see if Jones can tee off. Beletnikoff split about 10 to the right. Sherman is slot right. LaMonica back to throw. Fires to the sidelines, overthrown. Intended for Sherman at the 31-yard line. He was knocked down just for good measure by Kellerman, so the Raiders will have to punt. A while ago, I gave the score cue there 13-10. It's 13-0. Reese Morrison and Walt Sumner going back in double safety. Morrison at the 45 of the Browns. Sumner at the 35. And Mike Eichheit will punt from the 6. 7 minutes to play, first half. Low snap, kick is away. The line drive, Sumner on his own 34, up the middle of the 40, 45, he's to the 50, left sideline. Sumner to the 40, to the 35, he's to the 30, he's out of bounds, down on the Oakland 28-yard line, Walt Sumner. That's a punt that didn't get high enough and didn't give the Raiders time to get downfield under it. They hadn't even converged, and he went right up the center, and then he was waiting for a block. He thought maybe Joe Jones might be able to catch up and give him that one block he needed to go the rest of the way, but not quite. 49-yard punt, Browns out of the huddle. Damari's back in at left guard. Collins flank right. Hooker out five at left end. And Nelson drops the snap, but he falls on it. Back on about the 29-yard line. They'll mark it to 30. Second down coming, 12 to go. Browns have not been this far into Oakland territory in the game. Collins, flanking right, shifting out of the eye. Hooker's out five at left end.
Give to Kelly, right tackle.
Not much of a hole.
Fights and fights down to about the 26. Connors and Keating made the tackle.
Now we're probably in another with third down and about 8 yards to go. They've got to get down to the 18-yard line. You can expect Bill Nelson to go into the air on this one. And he wants to make sure that his receivers are deep enough to pick up the first down. So they've got to get at least inside the 20-yard line. If he does go in the air, we'll see in a moment.
Third and about 8. Collins flank right. Hooker out. 7 at left end. Nelson to throw. In the middle. Morin got it at the 20 to the 18 to the 17. First down, Cleveland.
Morin was wide open from the moment he took two steps downfield and then cut over the center. He was wide open, and Bill went back there, spotted him.
First down and 10 for the Browns on the Oakland 17.
Dempsey kicked a 62-yard field goal, and New Orleans beats Detroit
19-17.
62? That's what we have. We'll try to confirm it. 62-yard field goal, and Detroit loses.
That's got to be maybe off a fair kicker.
It could be.
Whew.
Where there's no rush.
Collins a slot right. Hooker split right. Give to Scott. Turning right end. 20. 15. Down at the 15-yard line. Bow could not get away from Grayson, the safety, who had him by one leg. There's a flag dropped at the line of scrimmage.
It appears to be against the Browns.
No. Defensive holding.
Holding against the Raiders. First down.
5 yards to the first down. 62-yard field goal is certainly a record. 56 was the record.
By 6 yards. That's a good point, though, Gibb. It might have come off a fair catch, because off a fair catch, you get a shot at a field goal with no rush.
That's some kick, huh? First down now for the Browns, and 10 to go on the Oakland 12. 4:39 to play in the half. Collins is the split end, now flanks to the right as the Browns have a flood formation. Give to Kelly, left tackle. No, not much. Still about the 11. Davidson, the man who jammed it up. That's awfully tough running against that big Oakland front four. Klein is probably the small man of the group at 230. Davidson's 280.
Here's the final, Kansas City over Houston, 24-9. Browns have two games coming up for the Oilers.
Second and about 9 at the 11. Collins flank right. Hooker up 5 at left end. Nelson hands to Scott. Right tackle to the 10. That's all. Another yard. Both on the stop. Well, 3rd and 10 now. 3rd and 8 rather. .35 remaining in the first half. Collins will flank right. Morin out a yard at right end. Hooker out 7 yards at left end. Nelson to throw. End zone.
Touchdown to Kelly.
That time he beat Otto. That comes with 3:15 remaining in the half. Touchdown pass from Nelson to Kelly. And then the Browns hit the scoreboard for the first time today, and they're still very much in this ball game. Now Mike Fitz will hold. Don Cockroft to attempt the point. Here's the kick. That's good. That comes with 3:15 remaining. The Browns now trail by 13-7. Now, Jimmy didn't think the Browns were going to throw that ball.
I didn't hear you what you said, Jeff.
You think the Browns weren't going to throw?
Oh, right. They had moved after that fine return by Walt Sumner down from the 29, almost the 28-yard line. In 3, 4, 5, 6, 7 plays, they were helped by a holding penalty, a defensive call, which, of course, is the automatic first down. But they're back in the ball game now with a spread of just 6 points between these two. The two field goals for Blanda, a short one, a 9-yarder, and
along 143 yards. And Cockroft is all set to give the ball back to Oakland now.
Alvin Wyatt, George Atkinson are the deep men. That's going a little short. Atkinson at the 10. 15-20. The right sideline. 25. And nailed at the 30-yard line.
Reynolds and Brown on it. And Darlington on their tackle.
Oakland starting on their own 30-yard line. Dixon and Smith and then the running backs again.
Oakland out of the huddle.
Sherman is split about seven at left end, making flank left.
Beletnikoff is split seven at right end.
Hand off, Smith, right tackle, knocked down at the 31-yard line. Jerry Shirk and Ron Snyder on the stop. Pick up of about a yard, second and nine. Browns defense shoring up now a little bit in the middle. Did very well in that last goal line stand, holding the Raiders to no gain after three running plays at the line. Two running plays in the pass, rather. Beletnikoff has split seven to the right. Sherman is the flanker to the left. Second and nine. Hand off to Dixon, right tackle. He is pulled down on the 33-yard line by Erich Barnes and Jerry Shirk. And a whistle on the timeout. We have a two-minute warning coming now. There's an official timeout on the field. The score is Oakland 13, Cleveland 7.
Nothing is less fun than having bills to pay. Unless it's having bills you can't pay. And this can happen, believe me, no matter how careful you are. Maybe you've got that problem right now. If you have, come on in and see the people at Household Finance. Sure, they say never borrow money needlessly. But HFC helps over 2.5 million families every year. And one out of every three has a bill problem like yours. So why not let Household help you too?
A good reason for borrowing is a good reason for lending. And the good place to borrow is...
Visit the household office nearest you. There are 18 offices in the Cleveland area. See your phone book for the addresses.
Warren Wells is going into the ball game. Very popular wide receiver now for Oakland. Gets a round of applause. San Diego leads Denver 10-7 in the second period. LA leads Atlanta 3-0 second period. And the Cardinals have shut out the Boston Patriots 31-0 under their new head coach.
Beletnikoff is split 10 to the left. Wells is the slot back to the left. Third down and about six.
And down goes LaMonica as he's hit by both Joe Jones and Jack Gregory, the defensive end, so the Raiders will have to punt. LaMonica slipped and then was belted down.
Aishai will come in to do the kicking. The Browns have taken a timeout to stop the clock with 1:55 remaining, hoping for field position after this punt. Because the Raiders are back on their 24-yard line. The deep man, of course, for the Browns will be Sumner and Morrison.
And the Browns' defense has really come alive ever since that goal line stand, which can help both the defense and offense, especially when you're behind 13-0 and you have very little to hang on.
Eichheit standing at the 10. And the kick is a high, beautiful spiral. Sumner calls for the fair catch, holds it. On the 28-yard line. We'd like to remind you again that if you care for a Cleveland Browns window decal, send the self-addressed stamp envelope to Decal, WHK Radio, 5000 Euclid Avenue, Cleveland, Ohio. That's a 48-yard punt. The Browns start play without the huddle now. Collins flank to the right. Kelly to slot left with Hooker split left. Nelson to throw. He's in trouble. Rolling to the left. He throws it. Incomplete at the 30-yard line. Intended for Bo Scott. Nelson was banged down at the 20. Scott was banged down by Lasky, the linebacker. Everybody else was covered. Second and 10. Clock stops, 1:37 remaining. Ball on the Browns, 28.
Gary Collins went deep on that one, just now getting back to the huddle. The tight end, Milt Morin, was in on that one and was open over the middle, but that was after Bill Nelson had to start running to the left, so you can't expect him to spot when he's in that particular position.
Oakland has three linemen now, four linebackers, their present defense. Kelly's a slot right, Collins split right, Hooker flank left. On the draw, Scott can't find the running room and gets knocked down at the 30-yard line. Just couldn't get up the middle. Lasky finally belted him down, and Lasky's a little shaken up on the play, coming to the sideline, hurt his right hand or shoulder. They're putting Oates, the tackle, back in. Third and eight. 1:15 remaining in the half. Collins, split right. Kelly is a slot right. Hooker, flank left. Nelson back to throw. In the middle. Kelly's got it. He's wide open at the 40 to the 45. Kelly to the 49 to the 50 and into the Oakland 49-yard line. Browns call timeout. 56 seconds remaining in the Browns cross midfield. Atkinson's the man who made the tackle. Kelly might have had more yardage had he not stumbled just after he caught the ball. He didn't go for the sideline. He was interested in getting it down for a possible field goal attempt. They'll have to pick up another first down if they expect to have Don Cockrell make this a 13-10 game at halftime. Of course, the idea of a touchdown either way is not out of the realm of possibility if Bill Nelson decides to go long. 56 seconds. The Browns were down 13-0 at one time and were able to score off of a fine punt return by Walt Sumner.
We've had that field goal by Dempsey pretty well verified. It was 62 yards.
We didn't find out if they were off the fair center, did we?
Not yet, we have. See what a new coach will do?
Yeah, look at what the new coach did up in Boston. They were shut out. I don't even know where that game was played. Was that in New Orleans? That's not to ask for this. Let's see here. Yeah, it's at New Orleans, and they just have the regular church.
Must have had a good tailwind.
56 seconds remaining. Kelly is a slot left. Hooker split left. Collins flank to the right. Nelson to throw. Ball on the 49 of Oakland. He fires. Collins open. He's got it at the 30. Collins dropped the ball at the 26, and it's ruled an incomplete pass. He juggled it as he was being knocked down to the ground by McClune and then couldn't hang on to it. It's ruled incomplete. See, Gary ran a great pattern to get... He was wide open.
What people don't know is that Gary is playing with very sore hips to make it real rough.
Second and 10, 49 seconds remaining in the half. The Browns trail by six. At one point, they were down 13. Collins will flank right. Hooker split five left. And Kelly is a wing back, a slot back to the left. Nelson to throw. He fires. Collins can't get it off his fingertips and incomplete at the 20. And Gary was bumped and then by Atkinson. And I think Atkinson also got his hands on the ball. So it'll be third and 10. Third and 10. And I can, Gary Collins is going out. And we can hear the coaches over the left. They get Homer in there. And here comes Homer Jones, number 85. In for Gary, who went deep on two consecutive plays. And of course, he's naturally winded. So that just moves Fairhooker over to the right side now. 43 seconds. The Browns would like at least 10 yards on the next play or two to get the field goal range. Hooker is flanked to the right. Jones split five at left end, and Kelly is a slot back to the left. Nelson to throw. Open. Bo Scott got it at the 40-yard line. It's not a first down. They have about a yard to go yet. I hope they know it, as they're going to go without a huddle, I think. They're lining up. 28 seconds. It is fourth down.
I didn't know it either.
Nelson throwing. There's the first down. Kelly's got it, and he's pulled down on the 34-yard line.
If Nelson didn't know it and centered that football, wouldn't that have been something?
He's got to get that pass out of bounds in a hurry because the clock is running with 8, 7, 6. Now he throws it out of bounds.
That's the 20. Everybody's booing, but... Homer Jones was in the general vicinity and about 3 yards away from it.
5 seconds showing on the clock, and the field goal unit comes out. Ball is on the 35-yard line, so it'll be about a 42-yarder. Angle left also at the hash mark. Phipps will hold for Don Cockroft's attempt. 42 yards. Snap. Spot. Kick is up. It's far enough. It's good.
and no time, there's the gun.
That's the end of the first half with the score, Oakland 13, Cleveland 10. We'll be back with halftime sports in the second half of today's game after the news. All right, the Oakland Raiders are all set to kick off to the Browns. It looks to me like they took a short halftime because we're going to have to forget that commercial just before the kickoff. We'll pick it up during a timeout or two in the second half. Here come the Browns now. They'll be receiving on a short end of a 13-10 count in the first half. Dixon had 22 of 8 attempts, and Kelly had 14 in 8 attempts. LaMonica was 5 of 13 for 57 yards. These are all official. Bill Nelson was 5 of 15 for 57 yards, identical. However, Bill had the one interception. Each had one touchdown pass, so it's mighty, mighty close, as you can see. As far as the total plays are concerned, 34 for Oakland and 34 the Cleveland Browns. Mike Eichheit has the ball teed up, and we're set for action. The Browns will get their hands on the ball to open the second half. Yep.
The deep men for the Browns are Reese Morrison and Homer Jones. There's the kick. Second half underway. Homer Jones under it at the 6. 10, right sideline, 15 to the 20. 25, 30, and down on the 33-yard line. Man who hit him is not on the program.
No, that's Manifac.
He was just activated for today's game. They'll spot the ball on the 32-yard line. So it's about a 26-yard return. The Browns starting the second half on their own 32, trailing by 3 points. Cleveland out of the huddle. In the stacked eye, shift out of it. Shift glass to slot end, tight on the left side. Hooker, flank left. Collins out four at right end. Hand off Kelly, right tackle, no hole. Fights for maybe two to about the 34-yard line. Davidson, the defensive right end, making the tackle. Our spotter, Harry Leach, has a piece of chicken in his right hand and a bun in his left hand. So if you hear any peculiar noises, that's him spotting.
Browns will use their bread and butter play now.
Hooker is flanked to the left. Glass out two at left end. Collins out five at right end. Hand off to Bo Scott, sweeping the right end. 35, 40. 43-yard line. Bo Scott on one of his rare sweeps. Connors on the tackle, along with Davidson, who pursued on the play. And that will be a Cleveland first down. Nose of the ball at a little over the 42. Browns out of the huddle. Hooker. Blank left. Collins out four at right end. Give to Scott, sweeping the end again. Blocked by Hickerson. He's up to the 45-yard line. A pickup of about three more. Left linebacker Bill Lasky made the tackle.
Well, in the first half, as you know, Gibb, they were unsuccessful going between the tackles, so perhaps they made this adjustment at halftime. You know, neither team was very impressive statistically, and it looked like the Raiders were really outplaying the Browns, which they did in the first quarter. But then that goal line stand brought life back into the Browns, and then they responded.
Second and seven. Normally, you can't run wide on these Oakland Raiders. Hand off to Kelly, left tackle, right to about the 48-yard line, went up over one of the tacklers, but Keating then caught him standing up. That'll be a pickup of three more. It'll be third down and about four to go. Cleveland, nose of the ball on the 48, their own 48. Raiders lead 13-10. We have 12 minutes, 5 seconds to play, third quarter. Jerry Collins will flank right. Tara Hooker splits five at left end, and Chip Glass out two at right end. Take handoff. Nelson under pressure. Throws. Hooker can't quite get it down on the Oakland 32-yard line. Nelson had to throw a shade early, as Oakland had the front four right on top of Nelson, and he threw it before Hooker got out of his pattern.
That's right. That wasn't the end of his pattern by a long shot. He was going to go deep, and all of a sudden he turned around and saw the ball in the air, and then he just kind of made a dive for it near the sideline, but he was going to go all the way.
Alvin Wyatt and Rob Sherman in double safety. Don Cockcroft to punt for Cleveland. Kick is away. Beauty. Way back it goes. Hits on the Oakland 3 and rolls into the end zone for the touchback. A 52-yard punt. Raiders will put the ball in play
on their own 20-yard line. Don't see any changes in either lineup. The Raiders out of the huddle. First time they've had the ball here in the second half. Biletnikoff flanks to the right. Sherman splits five at left end. Hand off. Smith, left tackle, head down to the 24. In on the stop for the Browns is Walter Johnson and Bob Matheson. Gain of four, second and six. Browns gave up a lot of yardage in the first quarter, then shored up the defense in the second period. See what happens now in the third, against the runs, that is. Biletnikoff again, flanks right, and Sherman with seven at left end. LaMonica to throw. Set, fires low at the 35, intended for his slot end, Ray Chester. Johnson, Walter Johnson, was right on LaMonica and might have bumped him. Now, Snyder is going out of the ballgame. And the Browns are putting in Joe Jones at left end on a passing situation now, third and six. I wouldn't be surprised about it if he was bumped because that was not only a low pass, it didn't even get there. I mean, it bounced like about 8-9 yards in front of him. We know LaMonica can throw better than that. Biletnikoff again flanks right, and Sherman splits left. And LaMonica to throw. Out of the way by Shirt. The tackle right out of LaMonica's hands. And the ball, in fact, ended up down around the goal line. So it's incomplete. And that time, they had the left side of the line had an X on. Joe Jones was going over the tackle spot, and the tackle had moved out around. His charge was wide to the outside. Eyeshide will punt. Deep men for the Browns are Morrison and Sumner. Eyeshide standing at the 10. Good snap. Kick is away. Beauty. High spiral. Fair catch held by Walt Sumner at the Cleveland 30-yard line. There's an official timeout on the field with the score, the Raiders 13, the Browns 10.
Household Finance. Well, here's why. The Good Place to Borrow began in 1878, so you know they've had a lot of experience solving money problems. The Good Place to Borrow says never borrow money needlessly, so you know they look at things from a sensible, thoughtful point of view. The Good Place to Borrow is the place where more people go when they want real solutions to real problems. If you've got a money problem yourself, remember.
A good reason for borrowing is a good reason for lending. And the good place to borrow is Household Finance.
There are 1,600 HFC offices throughout the U.S. and Canada. See your phone book for the one nearest you.
If the Browns didn't know it before, they learned at halftime that the Steelers have won their ball game. They've got to concentrate on this one, but you always hear those things because the Steelers are breathing right down their neck. Collins is slot left, and the pitch comes to Bolt Scott turning the end at the 35. He's down on the 35, and left guard John DeMarie pulled out to lead the blocking. Gus Otto, the right linebacker, made the tackle. He sort of sneaked behind DeMarie, who was putting a block on somebody else. So it's a pickup on the play of about five. Second down and five to go. Gives you an idea how fast guards have to be when they have a sweep like that and going almost, well, halfway the width of the field, and he is leading a runner like Scott or perhaps Kelly, any of the others. Hooker split right. Collins slot right. Glass out two at left end. Take handoff. Nelson throwing, and it's incomplete, intended for Gary Collins at the Oakland 47, and again they'll seem to throw the ball just a shade early, this time before Collins got into his pattern.
That's right, I think he was forced, and that was a fairly deep pass, and Gary had not turned around when the ball was in the air. Still the same score, no score in the third period, and we're almost 5 minutes into it. Next week, the Browns will be in Cincinnati.
54,463, the official attendance this afternoon. 54,463.
Browns out of the huddle with a third and five on their 35. Collins is slot right. Hooker is split right. Nelson back in the pocket. Fires. Out of bounds. Threw it right to Mike Fitch. So the Browns will have to punt.
Well, this is just about a repeat, Gib, of the opening minutes of the first period when they had four punts within, I think, a period of 6 or 7 minutes.
The deep men now for Oakland to receive the punt, Alvin Wyatt, Rod Sherman. Don Cockroft, the punt. He's standing now at his 21. Line of scrimmage, the Browns, 35. And a high, high, wobbly, fairly short kick taken by Wyatt at the 27. Hits the 30. Gets away. He really got hit by Randy Manier and Joe Jones on the 33-yard line. They may have to pick him up. Oh, did Jones and Manier hit him? It's only a 38-yard punt. Oh, he's coming off the field, all right.
Oh, that was one of those plays where he was almost boxed in back on the 27. He got free, and then he had no momentum going on his own, but Joe Jones had it all, and he just hit him head on and then he back.
9:48 remaining, third quarter. Poletnikoff has split five to the right. Sherman flanked to the left. Quarterback, Daryl LaMonica. Hands to Smith, trying to sweep left end. Turns the corner. 35, 40, out of bounds. On about the 43-yard line, Mark Matheson forced him out of bounds. Ernie Kellerman sprinted up from safety, but he got in behind the runner and let him turn the corner. He couldn't quite stay in front of him. That's the first down.
That young man, Charlie Smith, is the leading ground gainer. It isn't too impressive, but he has 46 yards and 10 carries, 4.5 yards to carry. Poletnikoff is flanked to the right. Sherman puts 5 yards at left end.
LaMonica to throw, left sidelines. Caught by Sherman, drilled right away by Walt Sumner in the 48-yard line. And again, Sumner, very fine position. A perfectly thrown pass, nobody can defense him. Here's Stuart Dixon coming out of the lineup and Miles Hubbard in the fullback. Gain of five for Oakland, second and five on their own 48. Now Poletnikoff is split about 10 to the right and Sherman is the slot back to the right. LaMonica hands the ball to Smith, dive play, first down. Into the Browns, 47-yard line. I may be premature. It's close to a first down. Snido and Matheson on the tackle. They're going to put the ball back to almost outside the 47-yard line. The end of that stick is just over the 47, about the 46 and three-quarter mark. And I don't think they have it. We'll find out. 9:16 remaining in the third period. They don't have it. They're going to miss it by about just a couple of inches. Jim, just now, the Browns made a change. They took Bob Matheson out of the game and have put Dale Lindsey at a middle linebacker, and I don't think Dale's been there all this season. He has been playing the outside. Here's Sherman, slot right. Poletnikoff is the end slip to the right. Give to Hubbard, straight ahead, fumble! Picked up by LaMonica, and he's knocked down on about the 46. He probably got a first down on him, and the ball is squirted almost back to midfield with a heads-up play by LaMonica. Probably got him the first down. It's good from here, anyway.
Yes, and I'm sure they did, and I don't even think they're going to miss that. I guess they are going to. They're going to bring it in, but I'm sure they got it.
The Browns didn't see the ball. LaMonica did.
Because now the ball is just exactly between the 46 and 47-yard line, and that's all they needed. They got it. By two lengths of the ball. First and 10 to go as they have moved now from the 30 down to the 46-yard line of Cleveland.
8:44 remaining, third quarter. No scoring yet in this period. Poletnikoff splits four at right end. Rob Sherman is flanked to the left. LaMonica throwing blitz on, and it is caught by Sherman, and he's caught out on the Browns' 40-yard line. That'll be a pickup of about six. Middle linebacker Dale Lindsey was blitzing. Sumner ran him out of bounds. Second and four.
That's just seven out of 17 for 62 yards and one touchdown for Daryl LaMonica. The yards on both sides of the line have come very hard this afternoon. So I guess you've got the credit for defense.
Sherman is the slot right. Poletnikoff splits end to the right. Hand off to Smith, trying to turn left end. He's hit at the 40, breaks the tackle, 38, and knocked out of bounds by Jack Gregory. At about the 38-yard line, Howell helped on it. That will be a little shy of the first down by a couple of yards. One of the Browns getting up slowly across the way is Sumner.
Someone had a good shot at him. I couldn't see who it was on about the 40-yard line, and he just moved inside him and picked up the extra 2 yards. Otherwise, he'd had almost a line of scrimmage play.
Third and two on the Cleveland 38, and the Raiders are now in field goal range. Sherman is a slot right. Poletnikoff splits 10 to the right. Chester tight at left end. Give to Hubbard, left tackle.
Fumble. It's rolling down on about the 37. Cleveland's got the ball. I believe it's Mike Howell. Mike Howell recovered. That's the second fumble in a row for Hubbard. The last time his quarterback picked it up just a few plays back, and now it's picked up by the Browns on their own 30, about 36-yard line, a little over the stripe.
So there's a break for Cleveland. See if they can capitalize. 8-9 remaining. 8:09, third quarter. Browns tail by three. They're in the stack eye and ship out of it. Hooker is the flanker to the left. Collins splits four at right end. Kelly straight ahead. Not much of a hole. Maybe to the 39-yard line. Yardage is very tough to come by today. That's a pickup of about two. Second and eight.
I think we can also credit or discredit, I should say, the condition of the field as far as curtailing the effectiveness of either running game.
Hooker, flank left, glass out a yard at left end. I think they want a different ball brought in. That one's a little wet, apparently.
And that'll tell you how bad the field is because the sun is shining. It's not raining, and yet they have to change the ball about every series.
Collins out five at right end. Give to Bo Scott, right guard and tackle. Just to about the 40, and that's it, another yard. That will be third down and a long seven. Seven minutes to play, third quarter. Oakland leads 13-10. Hooker, flank left. Glass out about two at left end, and Collins out five at right end. Nelson to throw. Uh-oh. It's incomplete at the 45, and Fair Hooker was down on the ground. Wilson knocked him down, and the ball was just sailing past him. And the official apparently didn't see it.
Well, I tell you, both of them were down on the ground, the right cornerback, Nehemiah Wilson. And had Hooker been able to get up and get that ball, he could have just kind of danced into the end zone. But he wasn't there.
Clock off the punt. Deep men are Wyatt and Sherman for Oakland at the 25 and the 15, respectively. Whoop, high snap. Cockroft got it. High, 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 wobbly kick. Wyatt called for the fair catch and holds it on the 18-yard line of Oakland. There's an official timeout on the field. The score, the Raiders 13, the Browns 10.
April 1966. Seth Plotzliebner pulls himself up to the table. He served, adjusts his napkin, and 90 seconds later, he's put away 17 sausages, a world's record. The 16 good sports Chevy dealers look up to a man like Seth because they have an appetite to break records, money-saving records on the 71 Chevy. And here's how you can save an extra $25. Rip the $25 record breaker coupon from the Good Sports Chevy Dealers ad in the Browns football program. Or write me, Gib Shanley, WHK, and I mail you one. And just one to a family, okay? Good. Now take the coupon to your Good Sports Chevy dealer. Look at the 71 Chevys. Pick out the one you want, order it, then show the salesman your coupon. He'll give you an extra $25 savings, and that's for the record. Yes, now's the time to make a record deal on the 71 Chevy. Because right now it's a buyer's market at the Good Sports Chevy Dealers. It's a fact. When you buy a 1971 Chevrolet, you win big.
Here come the Raiders out of the huddle, starting play on their 18-yard line. Beletnikoff split five right, Sherman slot back to the right. LaMonica hands the ball to Smith, trying to turn left end. 15-20, 25, and finally goes down on about the 29, and a beautiful effort by Charlie Smith went right through three of the Brown tacklers. Lindsay finally made the stop.
You know, that's the boy, Smith, who was the team's leading rusher last year. He's the boy that cut the top, caught the touchdown pass given in that game that was the Heidi game, you know, the one that they cut out. He's the boy that got it, and everybody was watching Heidi and quite upset about it.
We have 5:52 remaining here in the third quarter. Beletnikoff is split right, Sherman slot right. Hand off to Smith, dive over right tackle, off of the 35 to about the 36. Jerry Shirk hit him. And now the Raiders starting to move the football, and here's the lineup change for the Browns. John Garlington's coming into the right linebacker spot, replacing Billy Andrews.
And Charlie Smith has 72 yards in 14 attempts this afternoon. The Browns got to stop him.
Second down, about four. Hand off. Dixon, left tackle, 39-yard line. Picks up about four more, and very close to a first down, they'll measure. Lindsay on the stop.
They've really controlled the ball in this third period. The Browns have had it three times, but the only thing that really stopped the Chargers was that fumble by Hubbard. They're just an inch shy of the first down now.
Pete Panasak is coming in the lineup now for Oakland, replacing Charlie Smith. Third down, a couple of inches to go. Beletnikoff flanks to the right. Sherman out about 4 yards at left end. Give to Dixon. He fumbled. It's at the 40-yard line. I believe it is recovered by Oakland. That ball squirted right up in the air a couple of feet. So on the fumble, they get a first down. That's two of the three fumbles in this quarter. The Raiders have recovered themselves and both of them for first down. .36 remaining, third quarter. Oakland still leading, 13-10. Beletnikoff, flank right. Sherman out five at left end. Chester tight at right end. LaMonica hands to Smith, trying to turn right end. At the 40, 45, out of bounds, 48-yard line. Tim Houston ran the interference clear out to the sidelines, and nobody came up behind him to help on the tackle. Snido finally made the stop. Well, that's about an 8-yard pickup.
Well, that's what he's been doing, 7, 8, 9 yards on these last 4 or 5 carries. Up to 80 yards for the afternoon, and we still have 4 seconds remaining in the third period. No scoring after the halftime. At halftime, it was 13-10 Oakland.
Warren Wells is in now as a flanker to the left, and Todd is another new running back in the lineup. Hand off to Dixon, left tackle, 50 to Brown, 48. Caught standing up by Snido, fumbled it again, but the whistle will have blown the play dead. And it'll be a first down for the Oakland Raiders. And they're moving the ball. Smith trying to turn right end.
at the 40, 45, out of bounds, 48 yard line. Jim Houston ran the interference clear out to the sidelines, and nobody came up behind him to help on the tackle. Snyder finally made the stop.
Well, that's about an 8 yard pickup.
Well, that's what he's been doing, 7, 8, 9 yards on his last 4 or 5 carries.
Up to 80 yards for the afternoon, and we still have 4 minutes, 4 seconds remaining in the third period. No scoring after the halftime. At halftime, it was 13-10 Oakland.
Warren Wells is in now as a flanker to the left, and Todd is another new running back in the lineup. Hand off to Dixon, left tackle, 50 to Brown, 48, caught standing up by Snyder, fumbled it again, but the whistle has blown the play dead, and it'll be a first down for the Oakland Raiders. And they're moving the ball quite well now on the ground. Mark at the 48, just about where the nose of the ball is. Get a break after this play. 13-10, Oakland leading the Browns. Third quarter. Beletnikoff splits about 7 to the right, and Wells is the slot back to the right. Hand off, Dixon up the middle, 45, 40. He's still driving to the 36-yard line. Beautiful run by Dixon. Sumner finally made the tackle. 10 seconds for station identification. This is the Cleveland Browns Football Network.
This is WHK 1420 Cleveland, where you can follow the Browns with Coach Blanton Collier every afternoon at 5:30 and mornings at 8:35.
First and 10 for the Raiders on the Cleveland 36, and the Raiders have a drive moving now. Beletnikoff flank right, Wells out about 8 at left end. And off up the middle, comes Todd to the 30, the 25, and pulled down from behind on the 22. Picked up by Mike Howell, another gaping hole. Boy, he just went up on the previous play. Dixon, who picked up 12 yards, started like he was going to cut outside, and then went right up the center. On this one, Todd just exploded right up the center, and he's down at a 23-yard line. Something is wrong in there, but I can't see what it is.
Must assume some of it's linebacking, Jim, because some changes have been made during the game.
Beletnikoff flanks right. Wells out 4 at left end. Give to Todd, right tackle, hit at the 22, hit at the 20 again, and out of the 19-yard line, where Ron Snyder finally made the stop. Todd is not a big boy, 6'1", 185, not big at all for a running back, but he's tough to hang on to. That's a gain of 3. He comes from that school of good runners, Arizona State. Well, only 1:35 remaining in what has been a scoreless third quarter. And now Beletnikoff will be split to the left, and Wells will be the slot to the left. Ray Chester tight at right end. LaMonica's going to throw it. Looks, fires, deep, end zone. Out of the end zone, incomplete. And dropped anyway by Beletnikoff. And he had double coverage of Ernie Kellerman and Walt Sumner, but it was thrown out of bounds. With a minute 17 remaining in the third quarter, the Raiders have a 3rd and 7 on the Browns 19 and lead by 3. Beletnikoff has gotten good coverage by the Browns this afternoon. At least LaMonica hasn't gone to him too often, and of course he is one of the big receivers for the Oakland Raiders. However, Warren Wells, I believe, along with Ray Chester, their tight end, are the two leading receivers as of the middle of the season. And again, Beletnikoff will be split about 12 at left end, and Wells slot back to the left. LaMonica throwing on a big play. Pump, fires, incomplete. Intended for Dixon, broken up by middle linebacker Dale Lindsey. And the Raiders will go for another field goal. The Raiders did very well on the ground and then threw 2 passes. It's a 27-yard attempt, angle right, Blander to attempt. LaMonica will hold. Snap, spot, kick is up. No good. It's off to the right. There's an official timeout on the field to score. Oakland 13, Cleveland 10.
This is Bill Collins. Experts have said that rush hour traffic would be a lot smoother if more people commuted in carpools. It really doesn't take an expert to figure that out. More people per car, fewer cars, right? I'd like to invite you to join my carpool. It's called the BC Show, and it can be picked up any place in the greater Cleveland area Monday through Friday between 4 and 7 p.m. It'll help make your trip home from work a little less hectic and a lot more interesting. Here's some of the people you'll be riding with.
Marv Boone.
Dennis Buckle.
Don Kahlo.
Gib Shanley.
Bob Anderson.
Milo Town.
Those voices belong to men who tell you what's happening around the world and in your neighborhood, in news, in sports, in weather, and in traffic. They really do know what's going on, and if you're tuned to 1420, so will you. The WHK Traffic Watch may even help you get home a little sooner. When those fellows aren't on the air, I am, playing the kind of music I think you'll enjoy. Join the Bill Collins Carpool Monday through Friday afternoon from 4 to 7 p.m. We just happen to have an extra seat right now.
Was 1:09, third period, 13-10 the score. Browns huddling now back on the 10. They'll start from their own 20. And you saw something unusual. George Bland a missing one from the 32-yard line. But as we say, he's been hitting on only 50% of his field goals so far this year. But you don't know how long some of them have been. The first meeting between the Browns and the Oakland Raiders. Cincinnati next week, and then the following week, the Houston Oilers come in the last Sunday home game for the Browns. Their only other home contest will be the Dallas Cowboys, and that's on that Saturday afternoon, December 12th.
And plenty of reserve seats left for the Houston game. All right, Brown starting on the 20-yard line. Collins flanked to the right, and Nelson's going back to throw. He fires. It is incomplete. Intended for Kelly at the 30-yard line and broken up. A fine play by Lasky, the linebacker. Nelson was banged down to the ground by Ben Davidson, 6'8", 280 pounds. Well, I tell you, but you play a game against Davidson, if you're 6 feet to start with, you're about 5'8 when you get finished with him.
He's a real rough one.
Second and 10. Browns trail by 3. We've had no scoring yet in the third quarter, which shows 1:04 remaining. Hooker is split 5 at left end. Collins flanked right. Glass out about 3 at right end. On the draw. Scott in the middle. Gets about to the 22-yard line. Not much of a hole. Tackled by Otto. And by Lasky. And by Davidson. It'll be 3rd and 8. What a seagulls inside the stadium.
On that play, the clock is running. The Browns will get one more play unless they happen to go to the air and stop the clock on an incompleted pass.
Collins to slot right. Hooker split right. Glass out about 2 at left end. Nelson to throw.
Wide open. Kelly to the 30, to the 35. He's out of bounds at the 37-yard line. That stops the clock with 16 seconds remaining in the third quarter. And it's a first down. Lasky got him out of bounds.
And in that particular department, Bill is 6 out of 21.
One interception, one touchdown, 6 completions for 72 yards.
Browns out of the huddle. Hooker will be flank left. Chip Glass out 2 at left end. Gary Collins splits 4 at right end. Give to Scott, turning right end. Get in the backfield, breaks the tackle. He's to the 35, he's to the 40. He's still on his feet for 45. He's down the sidelines to the 40, to the Raiders 40. Both got to the 20, to the 15, 10, 5. Both got a touchdown, Cleveland.
63 yards.
A brilliant run by Bo Scotty. Almost went down at the 40-yard line. He had one hand on the ground, regained his balance, and ran all the way down the sidelines and took one of the Raiders into the end zone with him. And the clock shows 2 seconds remaining. That's some effort by Bo Scott. And for the first time today, the Browns have a lead.
That looked like one of the old Jim Brown runs against the Chicago Bears a number of years ago.
Point try now by Cockroft. Hips holding, spot, kicks up. It's good.
So with 2 seconds remaining, the Browns take a lead now, 17-13. That's 2 seconds remaining in the third quarter. And we'd like to again remind everybody who would care for a Browns decal to send to decal, WHK Radio, 5000 Euclid Avenue, Cleveland, and that includes all you servicemen.
And Gibb, with that 63-yard scamper by Scott, he's going to have a 100-yard game, I'm quite confident, because he had 34 unofficially, and that means he has 97 yards in 12 carries, and that's going to help his average immeasurably.
2 seconds remaining, as Gibb told you. Don Cockroft will get this ball in the air. It starts, the clock starts as soon as the
kicker kicks it, and unless it's the last 2 minutes of each half. So after their return, then it'll be the end of the third period.
Wyatt and Atkinson standing back at the goal line. There's a kick that's fairly well hit. Hits the goal post. That's twice the ball's hit the goal post today. So the Raiders will start play at the 20-yard line. The clock shows no time. There's the gun. That's the end of the third quarter. With the score, the Browns 17, the Raiders 13.
From a winner, you be a winner too. Enjoy a Duke. Join the Barons and the Cavaliers for excitement all winter long in the Cleveland Arena, the new home of Duke Beer.
Here come the Raiders, starting play at the 20-yard line. Sherman is a slot back to the right. Biletnikoff is a right-end split. Hand off to Dixon, trying to cut outside the end. He's hit in the backfield. Walter Johnson nails him back on the 18-yard line for a 2-yard loss. Mark at the 19-1-yard loss. Gregory helped on the tackle. See if that run by Bo Scott now put some juice in the Browns' offense and defense. Sometimes one play will do it. Second and 11, the ball on the 19. Browns still have Lindsay at middle linebacker and Garlington on the right side. Here's Biletnikoff, split left, Sherman slot left. LaMonica hands off on the draw, and Todd is trapped back on the 16-yard line by Jerry Shirk and Walter Johnson. That's another loss, and it's now third down and 14 to go on the 16. And Snido's gone out of there. Joe Jones back in the defensive left end.
And the people were booing the San Diego Chargers, and this is the first time they've been behind all afternoon.
You mean the Raiders?
The Raiders. Well, who did I say? Chargers?
Beautiful. Be a boo. And a draw, and again, Todd is caught, this time at the 15-yard line, and that time it was Gregory who hit him first, along with Shirk and Johnson. And they really are booing the Raiders now. Well, same every place, isn't it? Eichheid will punt to either Walt Sumner or Reese Morrison. Yeah, I bet the Raiders played so well up until that last series. They played rather well anyway. They weren't in it.
I'm very surprised, and you brought it out, Jeb. I'm very surprised the way he was moving that team on the ground, that he went in the air those two times when he had the ball on the 20. Very surprised.
Well, they want a new ball, I believe, or another one. Home team is responsible, I believe, to have 12 footballs ready for a game. Eichheid standing at the one. Safety men are back at the Browns 45. Good snap. Kick is up. Not too good. A little short. Sumner gets out of the way of the ball. It chases him, and now the ball rolls to the Browns 40. Freddie Summers almost got hit in the back with it. He turned around and did see the ball. There's an official timeout on the field with the score. The Browns 17, the Raiders 13.
Paycheck has shrunk, less overtime, high prices, more deductions, but those monthly bills and installments are as big as ever. Maybe it's time to rearrange your finances with a bill payer loan from Household Finance. Pay everything, then have just one payment a month to Household that's small enough to handle comfortably. Make sense? Then see Household Finance now. Household Finance.
For a large or small loan, visit the household office nearest you. There are 18 offices in the Cleveland area. See your phone book for the addresses.
Okay, the Browns starting play on their own 40-yard line and would like to have some ball control. 13:05 remaining. Hooker is flanked to the left. Milt Morin is the slot end on the left side. Give to Bo Scott, right tackle, 40. Tripped up, gets away to the 44-yard line. Extra effort by Bo, picks up a 4-yard gain on the play. Finally chopped down by defensive left end Tony Klein and Keating, the right tackle.
And that gives Scott 101 yards. You know, Jeb, you remember that he was also drafted by the Raiders when the
to Canada and played out his option in the first game with the Browns, but the Raiders had their eye on him.
I'd forgotten that. Hooker is flank left. Collins out four at right end. Morin splits a yard at left end. On the draw, Kelly can't find running room. Hits down to the 45, a yard pickup. The Raiders really clogged the middle up very well against draw plays, and most
timeouts remaining. Now a timeout has been called by the Raiders. That will lose them just one. 34 seconds. The Raiders only need to go about maybe 12 yards, and then they have a chance for a Blanda field goal.
I'll tell you one thing. If there were 1 second left to play right now, Gibb, they would go and let Blanda try a 58 or 59 yarder himself. They've got 34 seconds. Each team with one timeout remaining. They've got the ball. They've got Blanda quarterback. They've got Blanda as the place kicker. It's a pleasure to watch Blanda work. We must salute this man. They have both ends slipped. Sherman, flank left, back to throw, goes Blanda. Time, he throws it. A few restrictions. Dropped the ball. He just doubled it in front of him to Dixon, 4 yards in front of him. Dixon dropped it. 29 seconds to go. Second and 10.
I think perhaps he was so surprised that he even was getting that ball, because Blanda was looking deep. Brown dropped it to Adam covered. I wasn't watching. I was watching Blanda. And then he just kind of basketball passed it to Dixon, and he couldn't hold it.
Wells in to replace Sherman. Blanda to throw again.
He fires. It is incomplete. And a flag. Walt Sumner was down, Gibb. I don't know what they're going to call it, but he had lost his man, who was Warren Wells. Now they're conferring. Dale Lindsay's over there.
That may be offensive interference.
It could be.
Up against the Browns.
Against the Browns. On the 40-yard line. Now they're within field goal territory. The clock says 25 seconds.
Yeah, they'll try for another. They have a timeout left. They'll try to get a little better position. A little closer, too.
Well, it's all Oakland now with 25 seconds to play in a tie ball game. Oakland on the Cleveland 40. Poletnikoff is flanked right. Back to throw goes Blanda. He's set. He's hit. He's down all the way back on the 49 by Jack Gregory. That helps the Browns, and the Raiders take their final timeout with 21 seconds remaining.
Yeah, that could be the big play as far as the Browns are concerned. They have taken their last timeout, and now it takes them. It doesn't take them out of field goal range, but the possibility of Blanda hitting on a 55-yard one are indeed remote. 21 seconds. And before that, they were on the 40, so they could have tried a 47-yard field goal. If they go for it now, it has to be a 55-yarder. Rod Sherman going into the ball game. Wide receiver Biletnikoff coming out. Second down and big yardage to go, but that's of little consequence now.
Now, Sherman is in the ball game, and so is Wells. Both in there. And both are split. Here's Blanda throwing. It is caught, dropped at the 39-yard line. Wells grabbed the ball, and Kellerman slammed into him, and he dropped the football, an incomplete pass. 16 seconds remaining. Third down. 19 to go. The ball on the Cleveland 49, a tie ball game.
Well, we're going to find out in a hurry, because this is your third down play. Do they go for it on a fourth down, or would they try this long, long field goal?
If they catch the ball, Jim, he's got to get out of bounds, because
right.
Oakland doesn't have any timeouts
yeah,
left.
Hurry, he's got to. That's right.
Sherman is blank to the right. Both ends are split. Back to throw. Flag down. Bland is hit, and he throws it incomplete at about the 45-yard line. Now we have a flag dropped on the play, and a temper flare between George Blanda and Jack Gregory.
Now is not the time to lose your temper, boys.
You must assume that Gregory is not mad at the quarterback. He just knocked him down. Push him up.
A big 15-yard penalty against the Browns here would be just exactly what they don't want. This all came after the flag that was thrown by the referee.
If it's 15, the Browns might take it.
Oh, I think they would. 12 seconds, the clock says.
That'd be sure to get him out of field.
Illegal procedure against, I think, the Chicago Bears is a back in motion.
What did I say to Chicago?
Well,
we're a little more west than that.
It's against the Raiders. That was the initial call, and that's what it's going to be.
a back in motion against Oakland. Back to the 46-yard line, Jim.
Well, but it's still a third down. 12 seconds remaining. The Raiders will get an extra down out of that, but it does get them out of field goal range in case this next pass is incomplete.
I don't think they'd even try it, Jim.
I'm a little surprised that that's taking the penalty. Wells is split to the left. Here is Blanda throwing a screen to the left. It's stopped by Dixon. He's knocked out of bounds. That stopped the clock. The ball went out of bounds on the Brown 45-yard line. So the Raiders pick up 4 yards on the Browns taking that penalty. Instead of the 49, it's now down to the 45. And it's still fourth down. And the Raiders now going for the field goal. Here's Stabler in the hold. Blanda will try. 7 seconds remaining.
It's got to be a 52-yarder.
Yep.
Maybe 53.
Mike Howell is back in single safety. 7 seconds. It'll take it probably the whole seven. The snap. The kick is up. It's far enough. It's good.
Look, the Browns, you can well imagine, on the far sideline, almost in total disbelief. An unbelievable field goal by Blanda, who's also been quarterbacking here in the last quarter. Here's a kick by Eichheit. He does onside it. Taken by Pop Mathis, and he's racing for the sideline. Head down. He gets knocked down on the 37. The gun goes off. Finish. And this ball game is over. That's the end of the game with today's final score, Oakland 23, Cleveland 20.